gasping as he wakes, his weary eyes open. He looks upon the empty room, only lit by thin rays through the adjacent window. He looks out upon naught but the early morning moon and gentle rain. His back cracks up and down as he stretches lazily, unready to wake, yet too restless to sleep. What dreams is he plagued? In confusion and tired thoughtlessness, he lifts the journal kept in his bag and flips through a number of pages, stopping at a worn sheet held loosely by the bindings. A rough sketch looks back at him. A mountain, cloaked in tall evergreens and dense fog. He returns the book to his bag before lying down once more. His blank stare meets with the ceiling.
We'll be right back. between thee and the throne. I look to the heavens and how mockery
of the love of faith in my glorious incandescence.
Down like small stones on his back.
He strains his eyes to see the path once more, but is discouraged by its ongoing length. He spurs his horse to ride on faster, for the night comes quickly, and good men do not belong in the shadows.
Death from the lightning strikes the soaking ground. The storm reeks to end prophecies of doom. Omens of bitter days yet to come. Mr. Short upon a castle, seated on a distant mountain, the crown is there with the fool hides. His pitiable arrogance and desire drips like thick tar into the very air around the cursed place. The northern winds thunders around him, the furnace dread beneath his feet. The lich's black mark shall move through the stone like a cancer until the crown is returned.
He looks upon his township. His eyes meet with the precipices of stone and wood that bruised him in boyhood and haunted him as a man. He has returned to Asgore, but it is no longer the place from which he left.
I am so much more than what I showed you last. I was lost and yet I'm found. Hunting for the wretched crown. Yeah.
vast blankets of freshly fallen snow. The icy air nibbles at his tired fingers. He looks to the sky and is only met with grayer and more uncertain clouds. The ever-looming sun has begun to dim as the daylight hours grow weak. He rises as the night air beckons him toward the shrine.
Enter the snow! Enter the
Yeah.
draws his sword and calls out to the shadow. Silence is his only reply. After what seemed as many moments, he sheaths his sword once more. His head strikes the floor below. In a small clearing in the forest, unknowing of what has just happened to him.
Oh.
castle seems to groan as the trembling candlelight grows dim. A faint luminous spills from the floorboards as a skeletal and repulsive carcass cloaked in tattered black robes apparates before the night. The corpse lifts its wretched head, revealing sunken and wicked eyes as he gazes upon the crown, now clutched within the night's grip.